Hello everyone. Now I'm going to talk about a new feature we made in 21a, which is an improvement to the linearization feature. So prior to 21a, if you have a reference model that contains discrete states and you happen to configure this reference model in accelerator mode, during linearization, these discrete states will not be included in the linearization results. So this is a known limitation, and we would warn user that these discrete states are not included, and it will generally recommend you to turn the reference model into normal mode. But this is rather inconvenient because sometimes you may not even have the reference model file. For example, if the reference model is a protected model, you obtain it from somewhere else. So to better support the linearization in 21a, we made this feature. We can now fully support discrete states in the reference model that is configured in accelerator mode. Now let's look at this particular example. It's a feed rate control system. In the center, there is a reference model. Let's dive in a little bit. And we can see it contains a discrete time integrator. So it does contain discrete states. And it's been configured in accelerated mode. So now let's look at it. In 20B, which is without this feature, what's the behavior? Let's call linearization command here. Now you can see we've been given a warning telling us that the reference model is being configured in accelerator mode. Therefore, we would not actually linearize the discrete states inside it, and we recommend you turn the reference model to normal mode. And linearization result also kind of reflect that. It only contains D matrix, which means that the A matrix is empty, meaning there's no states. But we do see the discrete states inside this reference model. So that is the limitation. So now let's look at the 21A. Let's bring up the model. Exact the same model, exact same configuration, and let's try the same command, which is the linearize. And let's see what would happen with this new feature, with this new improvement. Now you can see the linearization completes with no complaints, no warning or anything, because we now natively support the discrete states linearization inside this reference model. And you can see the linearization result contains A matrix, which reflect the states, the discrete states inside this reference model. So that's this feature is about. This feature is going to be particularly helpful if you have a very large model that contains lots of a reference model that's been configured in accelerator mode. You no longer need to toggle their simulation mode back to normal for linearization. Thank you.